Hey, welcome back to the Mr. Excel Netcast. I'm Bill Jelen.
Basically, you start out with massive amounts of data. You say, how are we going to analyze this? Well, let's fire up a pivot table and see if we can solve this problem.
Hey, all right, welcome back to the Mr. Excel Netcast. I'm Bill Jelen. Today's question sent in by Dack, and oh, this is a challenging one. Dack says that he has words in a cell. He needs to break those words into exactly 20 characters and have that extend down from the original area. So, I mean, first of all, it's tough just imagine what this would look like. I tried to write in some sentences up here, use the LEN function to make sure they were all 20 wide, and then I used the concatenate function to put all those together into one big long sentence. So there's our concatenate function there. Let's convert that to values. And then I first thought, okay, well, let's use edit, fill, justify. That will word wrap something. And so I chose a nice big area here and use Alt-E-I-J. But unfortunately, because of our proportional space fonts, I'll just copy that length function down. You see that we get different size text messages in each one, you know, just because some like W's are wider, so you end up with more or less characters, and it did not work at all. But then I said, okay, well, what if we kind of go old school here? Let's copy this, and we'll do edit, paste special values, and I will change the font in all of these to one of the two fixed space fonts, either Courier or Courier New. So we use Courier New, and then use edit, fill, justify again, and check it out. That worked out perfectly. Now, before I did that, I had to set the column width, and it was not to 20, as you might expect. I ended up having to test it a little bit and go to 22.14. A little bit of work there to get it to work. Also, your last character has to be a space, and you see that space gets truncated, so we end up with 19 everywhere. Not really the way to go. So then I come back to a formula. I'm sure this is a formula that I got from Mike Gervin at Excel is Fun, although Mike is going to say that he got it from the Mr. Excel message board, so it's coming from all over. I used the mid function here, and this is kind of a funny formula in that I selected this whole range of 12 cells and then wrote the mid function that said, hey, we're going to take D12, and I put dollar signs in, and then I built a formula that's going to point to basically 1, and then 21, and then 41, and then 61. How did I do that? I said I want to take the row number of A1 to A13, that's the exact same height as what I selected, minus 1 times 20, so that way for the first cell, 0 times 20 is 0, add 1 to that, and say that I want 20 characters, and then finally Control Shift Enter, and sure enough, it splits it out perfectly, and let's just test it at a different font. Again, press Control Shift Enter, and it doesn't matter what font is, doesn't matter if you end in spaces or not, so probably Dack, the way to go is this wild, wild array formula that we entered in 13 cells all at once. Of course, if this is something you have to do all the time, it might be easier just to write a quick little macro that would go through and split things up in 20 character bytes. But a couple of ways to go, edit, fill, justify, or this array formula. Dack, thanks for sending that question in, and thanks to you for stopping by. See you next time for another Netcast from Mr. Excel.
Well, thanks for stopping by. We'll see you next time for another Netcast from Mr. Excel.